Brand new fallout for the FAA following the aborted landing of Michelle Obama's flight. Now planes carrying the First Lady and the Vice President are going to get the same oversight from agency supervisors that's already required for the President. On Monday, a civilian controller allowed the First Lady's flight to get way too close to a 200-ton cargo plane landing ahead of her at Andrews Air Force Base. Both the FAA and NTSB are now investigating. New allegations from the Tea Party that Democrats are trying to steal Wisconsin's Supreme Court seat, a seat that could prove pivotal in any court fight over union rights and collective bargaining rights in that state. The official tally shows Judge David Prosser won the seat by just over 7,000 votes. That's less than 0.5% of the total votes cast. Now his opponent, Assistant Attorney General Joanne Kloppenburg, is requesting a statewide recount, saying it'll be paid for by local governments. Take a listen.
Elections are about the future. I ran for Supreme Court to help restore confidence in our court and in our judiciary. Now, going forward, we must restore trust and confidence in the integrity of this and future elections.
Here now to talk about it, Amy Kramer, chairman of the Tea Party Express, and Mark Sawyer, UCLA political science professor. Welcome to you both.
Thanks for having me, Shannon.
Thanks.
All right, Amy, let me start with you. I mean, a recount, it's legal, it fits under the law. Why shouldn't she get one?
Well, you know, I mean, 7,000 votes, this is the highest turnout in voter history in the state of Wisconsin. She went and actually declared victory when she only had a 234 count, I think, margin. And Justice Prosser waited till the canvass was done before he declared victory. I mean, I think what's happening here is they're setting this up. They've brought in Al Franken's, you know, legal team to do these recounts, and their purpose is to recount until they find enough votes for her to win it. And they're trying to keep their base mobilized for the recall efforts that have started already.
Yeah, and that's just the next part of this that's going to play out. The state lawmakers being subjected to recall. That'll be another battle to watch as well. But Mark, I want to ask you, the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel has urged in an editorial today that this recount not happen, you know, saying it's going to be more divisive, let the state heal up. She's probably not going to find the votes. Why shouldn't she follow that advice?
Welcome to Tea Party America, where close counts and horseshoes and grenades and elections. Like, just count the ballots. That's what we need to do. It's not going to harm anyone to find out who really won this election. Look, you guys stopped this in 2000 with Bush. They stopped counting the ballots with the Supreme Court. And now they're trying to do it again. Just count the ballots. If he won, he won.
All right, but at a time that the state is having so many battles because they say their budget is in such disarray with huge debts coming in, this is not going to be a free recount. I mean, Mark, is this the best use of their money at this point?
We can't afford democracy now, right? That's Tea Party America, where we no longer can afford democracy. We send teachers pink slips, and guys like the Koch brothers and the hedge fund managers get record bonuses. These jokers are terrible. Welcome to Tea Party America. That's all I have to say. We can't afford a democracy any longer.
Amy, your response.
This is democracy. I mean, you know what? This is not Tea Party America. You want to label us as that to discredit us because we're having such an impact. Never before in American history probably have so many people been engaged in following what's happening in all these states. This is about the liberal left agenda, and it's about the legislation that Governor Walker and these Republicans have pushed through on the unions. That's the bigger picture. This doesn't fit into their narrative. It doesn't fit into their agenda, and so they're going to try to rile their base up, keep them mobilized going into the recall effort, and they're going to try to discredit us every way that they can. But you know what? The canvassing was done across the entire state of Wisconsin, and Justice Prosser came out the winner by 7,000 votes. I mean, I don't know why that can't stand, but you know what? Let them recount it. Yes, it's not the best use of money. Let them recount it, and you know what? I guarantee you Justice Prosser will come out a winner again.
And Mark, if the judge comes out on top, do you think it settles the debate? Will there still be questions about how this whole election went down?
Anytime you find just enough votes for the margin of victory after the election is seemingly over, there's always going to be questions. But
well, you know,
I'm glad Amy conceded the point.
Just so we can clarify that situation, there was a county clerk who was involved with canvassing the votes after they came in. There was a discrepancy of some 7,000 plus votes. But what she said was that, listen, it was a processing error of putting in data. There were Republican and Democratic members of the canvassing board who stood with her and said, we watched the whole process. It was an open process. And that's what canvassing is for, to find these mistakes. I mean, Mark, are you suggesting there's more to it than an innocent mistake?
I don't know. I mean, let the recount happen and let's see. I mean, I'm for openness of government, right? I'm not sure if that's a Tea Party value or not, but us lefties like openness in government, and let's have it.
All right, Amy, quick final word to you.
No, I mean, we're all for openness and transparency. Again, as I say, I'm sure that Justice Prosser will come out the victor in the end. But the canvassing was done. I mean, are you saying that there was a problem with the canvassing that was done across the state? Justice Prosser waited to declare victory after that. I mean, what they're doing is they're setting up the debate so they can all of a sudden say, hey, we found some ballots in some trunk somewhere. I mean, we've seen this happen over and over again. The count should stand. Justice Prosser is the winner. But if they want to have a recount, waste the money. I'm not surprised. He'll come out victorious again.
All right. Amy and Mark, we thank you very much. And just to note for the record, after the election in 2000, they did some follow-up recounts in Florida, ultimately putting President Bush into the White House. We know Mark's not going to want to resolve that issue here today. But we'll have to leave it there. Thank you both for your time.
Shannon, it always goes back to President Bush, no matter what.